Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. And two, for you to experience a new thing according to the scripture where we've been reading, one, you must have eyes to see. That is why he said, see. See. Let's go there. I want you to see it well. See. Why did he have to call you to see? Because what you cannot see, you cannot behold. You cannot have it. It's only what you see you can fight for. It's only what you see you can really lay hold on. So he said, shall you not see it? So you must, you know, we've been praying and I was just saying, what do I now have to say? Now mama is just praying everything and he's just doing it all together. Hallelujah. The spirit is one. This is what he says. He says, 19, for I am about to do a brand new thing. See. Many of us, the truth is that we don't see. We don't see. Yes. Do you think it's everybody that his eyes are closed that are blind? There are some that have eyes and they can't see. They have eyes, they can't see. He says, see. What are you seeing? What are you seeing? It said God to call Abraham in the book of Genesis chapter 10, I think verse 14. When Lot has carried the good of the land. When Lot has carried the better part of the land. Do you know what he told Abraham? Abraham was looking at an empty land. Abraham was looking at a dry land. Abraham was looking, Lot has carried the green pasture. Lot has carried the side when there is water. And God had to come to him. The Bible says in verse 14, Genesis 10, 14. You see, and the Lord came to him. And told Abraham, he said, see, lift up your eyes. Look. Look. You have to pray. We will pray. I say, God, help me to see what you want me to see. Mm-hmm. Abraham sat down, was lamenting, I believe, and I presume. Hi, Lord has carried the grain of the land. Lord has carried the water. And I told Lord to choose first. And Lord has chosen first. Now, what do I feed my flocks with? What do I do from here? But God, it takes God to take him and say, see, look. As far as you can see. What do you see? You want to see a new thing? Then you must be ready to see. You must be ready to see. You must be ready to see. Yes, it's not, the hand of God is not short, but your eyes are closed to see. God is telling you, take a step, and you are just saying, if I live here, where do I start from? God is saying, look, daughter, I have set a place ahead of you. But you are saying, I know this is my comfort zone. You have to see. Don't always set your eyes on your comfort zone. You want to see a new thing. Most times, the new thing does not come in your comfort zone. It comes when you look afar. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. And the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 23 told us something. He said the eyes is a lamp of the body. He said when your eyes is good. My sister said if you don't know any other prayer to pray today. Even when you live here, begin to pray it and say, Lord, help me to see. Open my eyes that I may see. People were running out of Egypt saying, okay, people were running out of their comfort zone. They want to go to Egypt because there is famine. But God told Isaac, stay here. Everybody was running helter-skelter. There is famine, there is this. But God has to open the eyes of Abraham and say, Abraham, though Lot has gone, but see. You have to tell the Lord, open my eyes that I may see. You want to see a new thing. New thing can be taking place here and now. You will not still see. So you have to ask God. He says, see. And the Bible makes us to understand in the book of that Matthew 6, 23. He said, your eyes is the lamp of the body. He said, if your eyes is good, the whole of your body is good. My sisters, at times our eyes are not good. Yes, Holy Spirit, help me to speak now. Our eyes are not good. You see evil everywhere. And because you see evil everywhere, evil begins to chase you everywhere. Eh? The Bible says, as a man thinketh, let me tell you, let me use my own, let me paraphrase. As a man seeth, that is how it happens. So what do you see? You see devil everywhere. Devil begin to chase you. Where is God now? Because your eyes is not good. So you begin to see things that are not good. Do you know God called light out of darkness? So if you are seeing darkness, because your eyes are open, you see that God is calling light out of that darkness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, if your eyes is good, the whole body is full of light. Yes. Mama was talking, see, and God said, let there be light. And I want to interpret it in my own word. Light is understanding. Let there be an understanding. Yes, you can get to a place that is so rough, is so rugged. Everybody's running out. But when God gives you an understanding, it becomes your land.
Hallelujah.
Because your eyes are open to see the needs that is in that land. Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
So your eyes, look, if you don't have any other prayer for this year, say, Father, open my eyes. When God open your eyes, you don't see as men see. You don't see men walking like trees, but you see the way God wants you to see. Men have been seeing impossibility, but you are seeing victory.
Hallelujah.
Because why? See, I will do a new thing. New thing does not come at ease. If you further read, the mama was preaching it. Let's look, what is wilderness? Wilderness situation is a very terrible situation. A very terrible situation where you are left alone most times. You have no husband, you have no brother, you have nobody to stand by you. Wilderness situation. He says, see, even in that wilderness, I'm going to give you direction.
Amen.
Wilderness. Yeah, I will do a new thing. He's not going to do it anywhere. He parted the Red Sea that he was telling the children of Israel in Isaiah 43 verse 17. I parted the Red Sea. I did this. What happened before he parted the Red Sea? Red Sea did not part in his own accord. They were being chased by an enemy. They were between the Red Sea and their enemies. And God looked. They were not running up and down. But because they look unto God as a slave girl look unto the master. That's what Psalm 122, 123 says. He said, as they look up to the master, and the master did what? He parted the Red Sea. I said, ways to experience. Ways to experience a new thing. You must be ready for the wilderness situation. Let nobody deceive you. Tough time will come. Even the most anointed goes through tough time. The most anointed go through tough time. It is when tough time, when the wilderness come, that is when you see God making a way. In that wilderness, men may conclude you are going to die there. Men may conclude that nothing good is going to come out. Men may conclude so many things. It's possible. They are going to say so many things. But God said, I should say to you, he said, I will make a way. In that wilderness, in that confused state. You know, when I began to look at what is wilderness? Wilderness is an environment not habited, very difficult to live in, no life. It says because of the hot weather or the cold weather. You know, it's a place where you are alone. I don't know many of us that are alone in a marriage. Yes, we are anko. Wearing anko does not mean we are very happy. So many of us are in wilderness in our houses. Yes, we just wear garments. We are single. Praise the Lord. You are in the wilderness. My sister, if you go on your knees, there is a God that answers in the wilderness.
Hallelujah.
There is a God that makes a way in the wilderness. But for him to make a way, you must see, look. See. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And two, three, if you're writing, you must be very, very patient. The sea did not part as they were just running, Israelites, Egyptians, and God there. And the sea made, no, there was a time Moses had to pray to God. And there was a time God had to respond to Moses' prayer. Praise the Lord. There is a time you have to be patient with God. If you must see a new thing, you must learn to be patient. You must learn. Patient is a virtue. You must learn it. You must learn to be patient. So many people want to see their new thing. But the land that God has promised them, I will do the new thing. You are out of the land already. You are in Egypt. And God is telling you, I will do it in Zaragoza. You are out of here. Naomi, they went because of famine. They went, everybody. But there were people that were still there. But they left. They left. Because the hunger was too much. The pressure in the wilderness is so much. Pressure is so much. But there were people that waited. And the people that waited, why Naomi and his family left, Naomi came back and met all of them correct. He met all of them correct. And when they called her Naomi, she looked at them and said, no, I am not Naomi, call me Mara. Because why? Look at Sister Stella, Sister Bosse, Sister BC. They are now maritally settled. They have their children. They didn't have documents while we're living. They have their documents. They have their houses. They are okay. Because why? You run ahead of God. If the Israelites were running, God would not pass the Red Sea. They stood. Moses says, stand still. Stand still. If you want to experience a new thing, you must learn to be patient. 4. I said you must understand that God himself arranged things in the realm of the spirit. So your spiritual eyes must be open. And I pray for everyone as I pray for myself, that every scale covering our eyes from seeing the reality of what God has for us, I command that scale in the name of Jesus, fall off now. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Yes. I don't know the area. I don't know the area. You must learn to stand still. You must learn to stand still. He said he's going to make way in the wilderness. And now let's look at the desert condition. You know when you say, you are blessed, new thing is happening, everybody's jumping, shout amen. There is a wilderness and there is a desert. So if there is no desert, if there is no wilderness, there won't be path. If there is no desert, there won't be water. He said he's going to make path in the wilderness. And that path, direction. You will not lack direction.
Amen.
And when you have direction, forget it now. In fact, the heaven, the sky is your starting point. When you have direction, he says, look, I am going to make a way for you. I wrote something here. I said, wilderness is a hopeless situation. Hopeless situation, difficult, lonely, desolate, frustrated, rejected situation that you just see, you are just there on your own. Nobody wants to associate with you. People will even see your phone number, they will drop. As you are calling, they will just put it on busy. You say, what is the matter? Am I the cause of her problem? Those are those kind of situations. Very terrible, horrible. Nobody wants to associate with you. They only make friends with you behind when there is no much crowd. When there are much crowd, they greet you from afar or they wink eyes to you so that they don't associate with you, because to them you are a wilderness. There is nothing good coming out of Egypt. There is no from Nazareth. Nothing good is coming. There is nothing good coming out from you. There is nothing good to be associated with you. So why do I have to hang around this person? But they forget. They are forgetting, or they refuse to remember that it is God that makes a way even in the wilderness. Then let's look at the desert situation. Okay, before I go there, I said you must recognize that God is the master of the ceremony. Each stage of your life, I refer it as a ceremony. God is the master of it. Yes. You see, Mama was talking about Ruth. Why was home? This is a note I wrote from home. Mama was talking about Ruth. Ruth was looking at Naomi. She was seeing a way in the wilderness through Naomi. But Oprah looked at Naomi. If you think I am lying, when you read the book of Ruth chapter 1, 12 and 13, when Naomi told them, he said, look, stop following me, because I am old. Or peradventure, if I have a son, I give birth now. Will you wait for this child to grow so you marry? Oprah realized and said, this is wilderness situation, desert. Kai, I reject, I bind, I reject, I bind. I believe the woman didn't finish before he hugged her and said, Odabo. Told Mama, bye-bye. But do you know what? Oprah was seeing the wilderness, was seeing the desert situation. Yes, Mama is very right. Ah, Mama, God bless you for opening my eyes. So I would have just died foolishly with you. God forbid. She walked her way. But Ruth, because her eyes were open, it takes an unbeliever's eyes to be open to see the God in you and say, I want to follow your God. Yes. Moabite, they are not Christians. Go and study your Bible. They are not Christians. They are unbelievers. So she saw the God in Ruth and said, this God can still bring water from the desert.
Amen.
And he began to follow Ruth. He said, Ruth, Mama, your people will be my people. Your God will be my God. I believe Mama will still look back. Go. Ruth was seeing the future. She was not seeing the desert, but she was seeing, because her spiritual eyes were open. Her eyes was good and her eyes was full with light, and she could see the good ahead.
Hallelujah.
I said, if I follow this woman, my end will be very great. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I said new things are made for people who genuinely look up to God for help. New things does not happen to anybody that is not ready, because that would be misuse of resources. When will God give you money when he knows you cannot even help the one that is around you? He won't give you now. Praise the Lord. God will not give you what he knows you can't use for him. Praise Master Jesus. So new things are given to those who genuinely look up to God. What are you looking up to? What are you seeing? What are you seeing? Now, I said, look at the marriage ceremony. The marriage ceremony in Cana of Galilee. Jesus turned water into wine. That was a new thing. Yes. The pot was used to carrying water. But that day, you know, Mama said it can be fresh, afresh, something afresh, something fresh, something new. Yes, so that pot is a container to carry things, but to carry water, especially it was a water pot. But that day became a wine pot.
Hallelujah.
It became a wine pot. That was a new thing.
Hallelujah.
That was a new thing in the land of Galilee. It was in our presence, we poured water inside the pot.
Hallelujah.
Now he said, now bring it out. And we are bringing out this water. It became wine. Let me tell you one thing. The new thing that God is about to do in our lives, men, we attest to it.
Amen.
I said, men, we attest to it.
Amen.
Women, we attest to it.
Amen.
Kings, we attest to it.
Amen.
Nobles, we attest to it.
Amen.
If you look at that portion, I think John 2, the Bible makes us to understand that the master of the ceremony now asks, how come are you bringing the last, the best for the last? Hallelujah. But little did he know it was a new thing. Nobody told him that this wine was made, but the wine made name by himself. This year, God will make name for you.
Amen.
God will make name for you.
Amen.
As you have genuinely come to seek him for a new thing.
Amen.
He said, nothing good will he withhold. And today I pray in the name of Jesus, as I pray for you, I pray for myself, that new thing, we embrace you,
Amen.
We embarrass you,
Amen.
We encamp you round about,
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That thing that you cannot hide, that men and women will begin to they will begin to attest and say, how come? Is it not you? Why is it now that you are doing it? Because God has stepped into it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said I will liken wilderness to be shame, outright shame and confusion. Wilderness to be, how do I call it, disgrace. You don't just know. You know, tell me, somebody will just, you too, you they happy? What are you not happy for now? Somebody once told me, Ma, I think I've shared it with you. He just looked at me and said, Ma, when they go to education again, I sat down and kept quiet. Why? He said, no, you'll be going to people's dedication. Maybe they will be thinking when we didn't come to your own. Inside my heart, I said, that is just this person's thought.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? But one thing I know that I'm certain about is God makes a way in the wilderness.
Yes.
That God brings forth water in the desert.
Yes.
And he talked about the desert. He said he's going to bring forth water. Desert is a barren land. And water is life. I don't know how someone that is in a desert of their life, in a barren land of their life. You know when we say barren, we just think a woman that does not have a child. Look, somebody that studied to pass and failed is barren. Somebody that did business and failed is barren. That was not his expected result. The expected result was perverted. So that is barrenness. And the desert is a barren ground. It's a dry land. It's sandy where there is no water. And God said he's going to bring water there. In other words, when God bring water into your desert, my sister, people will you, they will not begin to take shelter under you.
Amen.
Because yes, desert, when water is in desert, look, it signifies life.
Amen.
So life is coming into your desert situation. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't know who has tagged you that this person is a desert. I don't know who has tagged you and said, okay, there is desert around this fellow. But I decree and I declare by the power in the name of Jesus that water shall spring forth from your desert. In the mighty name of Jesus. I say water shall spring forth from your desert. In the mighty name of Jesus. When water is in the desert, everybody will stop and drink. They will stop and drink. Including those people that called you desert before. They will stop and drink.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. When the wilderness becomes, when there is a way in the wilderness, it becomes a channel of blessing where people just, I want to go and pluck there is something there, let me go there. People will begin to call because God has placed direction. I speak direction into every disorganized area of our life. In the name of Jesus, that the light of God and the direction of God will break forth now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, precious Father. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Lastly, let me round off with this. I said a desert. A desert is a reproach. Desert. When I checked the definition, it says it's an infertile land. It's a barren land. It's a sand land. It's an uninhabited land. It's a forsaken land. It's a place that, in fact, you don't see anything. I have some brothers that came through the desert when they told me their experience. Say, Mama, somebody will jump for the sand will cover immediately. That is to tell you how it is. But listen to me. God said he's bringing water out of the desert. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Stand up as we open our mouth to pray. We want to pray. We'll take two prayer points. You are going to say, Father, every desert situation around me, Father, let there be water now. In the name of Jesus, shall we open our mouth as we begin to pray. Father, in the name of